Take one. Hello, friends. So good to see you. I have an important... No. This is not gonna work. Sorry, Oipe. Take two. Hello, my dear family. Family who are friends. Blah, 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 blah. Okay. Take three. Hello, dear friends. Having to do a few takes of my message got me thinking about the lesson of doing many takes. You see, each scene in a film is filmed multiple times. Take one, two, three, sometimes even hundreds. And friends, I'll let you in on a little secret. Even recording this message demands two takes, sometimes a few takes. But all you see on Facebook is the final product, which is all hunky-dory and classy, I hope. But there's always a first take, first draft of the idea that I wish to present, which needs to be rehashed and reworked. Same thing with music. A singer can be in the studio for hours singing the same melody over and over and over until it's perfect. There's always a behind the scenes that we, the viewers and listeners, never see, right? And yet, we don't consider the need for another take to be a failure. No, it's an opportunity to do things even better. So why am I bringing this up? Because second chances is the theme of a mini holiday happening this Monday. It's called the second Passover, Pesach Sheni. In biblical times, this was the second chance to do the Passover rituals if one wasn't able to get it right the first time. So we commemorate this day by eating some matzah and thinking about the incredible message about second chances. There's always another take. There's always the ability to fix. In the words of the great Reb Nachman of Breslov, if you believe that you could damage, then you should believe that you're able to fix and repair as well. Instead of beating ourselves down for missing an opportunity or for failing at the first try, we ought to dust ourselves up and go at it again. There's always the second Passover. Cut. Scene ends. That's a wrap. Shabbat Shalom. We love you.